With 89 Premier Class MotoGP wins, Valentino Rossi has more to choose from than any other rider in history. But which ones make it into his best of the best? From the 2000 British GP to the 2017 Dutch TT and counting, Valentino Rossi tops the all-time list for most world championship race wins in MotoGP's Premier Class, to give him a multitude of options for which could be his best. Picking out the firm favourites from the 89 wins notched up so far, it is time to decide which marks Rossi's finest hour. On the cusp of his first Premier Class world title, Valentino Rossi went to Phillip Island needing to finish in either first or second place to seal the crown with two rounds to spare. Max Biaggi was his sole remaining challenger, and despite starting from pole position, he dropped down the pecking order early on, leaving Rossi to battle for the lead against Alex Barros. But with Phillip Island's circuit characteristics producing the typically closely contested race, a five-rider fight broke out, including Rossi and Biaggi. That was the case until mid-race distance, when Rossi began to pull clear of his rivals, who were scrapping for the podium places. Biaggi responded to bridge the gap and retake the lead from Rossi with 10 laps to go, which duly brought the chasing pack back into contention. Biaggi and Rossi continued to trade overtakes for the lead in the closing laps, but the doctor could remain composed, knowing second place to his rival would still be enough to seal the title. But on the final lap, Rossi wiped the nose of Biaggi into the MG corner and held on for victory by just 0.013 seconds. To date, Rossi's smallest ever winning margin to take the title in style. The 2004 South African Grand Prix was certainly one of the most emotional wins in Rossi's career, as he made his Yamaha debut after moving on from Honda following his three successive Premier Class world titles. Starting from pole position, Rossi was pursued by his bitter rival Max Biaggi, with the Italian keeping closest to the reigning world champion. But to the surprise of most of the MotoGP paddock, Rossi was instantly on the pace with the Yamaha, following a short winter of adaptation to send out an ominous warning of what was to come. Biaggi, to his credit, fought Rossi for the entire race, with the pair trading overtakes as he looked to spoil his rival's dream debut. But Rossi held on to become the first rider in history to win consecutive MotoGP races on different manufacturers. The feat proved too much for Rossi, who was in tears on the cooldown lap to create the iconic first image of the Italian's Yamaha years. Having seen off most of his rivals across the early stage of his Premier Class career, a new generation were challenging his domination in the shape of Nicky Hayden and Casey Stoner. Looking to regain his crown, Rossi faced off against Stoner in an all-time classic at the iconic Laguna Seca circuit in 2008. On the opening lap, Rossi gave chase to Stoner, pulling off his first overtake at the breaking into the corkscrew, which hinted at what was to come. On lap 4, Rossi repeated the move down the corkscrew in arguably one of the most famous overtakes in the sport's history, as the Italian ran over the curb and off the track, coming down the steep banking to keep the lead against Stoner. With Stoner demonstrating superior pace in practice, Rossi took every opportunity to keep in front of the Australian rider to trigger an almighty back and forth between the pair over the opening laps. With 9 laps to go, Stoner pressed Rossi even harder, forcing the Yamaha rider into an incredible defensive move around the outside, before the Ducati rider braked too late for turn 11 and came off behind Rossi. That allowed the Italian to ease to victory and deliver a key psychological blow against his rival in the fight for the 2008 title. Another of the one-on-one battles against an emerging challenger. This time it was Yamaha teammates taking on each other, with Jorge Lorenzo looking to beat Valentino Rossi in Barcelona in 2009. The Yamaha pair produced untouchable race pace from the start to shake off the chasing Casey Stoner on the Ducati, with Rossi leading his teammate until Lorenzo started to make his move in the final 5 laps. That erupted an all-out attack from both riders to keep the lead, which duly produced some of the greatest racing witnessed in the modern MotoGP era. The last lap alone makes for 2 minutes of pure drama. Lorenzo charging by using the slipstream on the main straight, Rossi around the outside at turn 3 before switching back to the inside at turn 4, only to have Lorenzo bite back on the exit of turn 4. With no way through at turn 10, Rossi had to create an overtake never witnessed before at the Montemello track. Under braking to the final corner, Rossi tucked inside Lorenzo, having been shown the tightest of lines, and held it together to charge to the checkered flag by 0.095 seconds, to the amazement of the entire crowd. The race also represented another battle for control of the MotoGP championship, with Rossi, Lorenzo and Stoner tied on points at the end of the race. Both Rossi and Lorenzo jumped out of Parc Fermé to celebrate in front of the crowds in the main grandstand, as tensions between the pair continued to rise. In the dramatic and often controversial 2015 campaign, Rossi's greatest hour came at Assen in a showdown against Marc Marquez. Somewhat uncharacteristically for Rossi over the latter stage of his career, the Italian started from pole position and held onto the lead in the sprint to the first corner. With Marquez in hot pursuit, the action erupted with 7 laps to go when the Repsol Honda rider dived into the lead under braking for the first turn. Rossi used the opportunity to assess the Spaniard's strong and weak points around the track, and with 3 laps to go, he bolted back into the lead up the inside at Mandaven. Rossi's attempted breakaway gave him a brief respite, setting his personal best lap on the penultimate lap, but Marquez was far from beaten. Clawing back time over the final lap, Marquez launched himself up the inside at the final chicane, looking to push Rossi aside. But the Italian held his nerve to keep track position to see the pair bash fairings, sending the Italian skipping across the gravel trap to take the checkered flag ahead of the Repsol Honda rider and seal his 85th career win in the top class. What is your favourite Valentino Rossi win? Do you think he can achieve one in this wild 2020 MotoGP season? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe to Crash MotoGP.